For question number 16, the correct option is B. And to show you the steps of solution, let us first note down for the two satellites of a planet, their mass ratio, M1 upon M2, that is given to be 2, and orbital radii, they are in the ratio R1 by R2 is equal to 1 by 4. We shall need this again and again. Now in step number 1, looking for the ratio V1 upon V2, where V is the orbital speed of a satellite. Now, from my theory class, we have learned that orbital speed of a satellite around a planet, standard formula, V orbital is equal to square root of g into m by r. Here g is the gravitational constant, universal constant. M is mass of planet around which satellites are revolving, also a constant here. Now, r is the orbital radius. Therefore, we can write down that ratio of orbital radii for the two satellites, V1 upon V2. Is equal to, with an eye on this formula, for satellite 1, this ratio should be, well, what is V1? That is G into M by radius of orbit, that is capital R1 under square root. Similarly, V2 will be square root of GM by R2. The GMs cancelling out, we have got square root of R2 upon R1. Since R1 by R2 is 1 upon 4, square root of R2 by R1 is simply 2. So we have got V orbital, that is orbital speed ratio, V1 by V2 is coming out to be 2. That corresponds to a matching, let me write it here. In list number 1, the element P is matching with element 3 in list number 2, isn't it? Now, once you get here, let us talk about the shortcut. Look at the options once again quickly, given in the question. And you see, luckily for us, only in option number B, the element P corresponds to element 3 in these two lists, and therefore you can simply stop here and say we have got our solution and B is the answer. That is a shortcut method. I repeat once again, in a problem, in a question paper where time is important, you must stop here and go no further, because you already have got a result that corresponds to only one option, that is option B in the question 16, and therefore you must stop here and move on to the next question. But having said that, let me, for the sake of completeness, show the other results also. Wait for a moment. In step number 2, we show the ratio of angular momenta of the two satellites. And we know for a particle moving in a circle of radius r, angular momentum is given by the formula L is equal to m into v into r, where m is the mass of the particle, v is the linear speed of the particle, in this case satellite, and r is the orbital radius. So we have the ratio, let me write it here, L1 upon L2 for the two satellites, that is M1 upon M2 into V1 upon V2 into capital R1 upon capital R2, isn't it? M1 upon M2 given to be 2 in the question. V1 upon V2 found here, that is 2 again. And R1 by R2 given in the question to be 1 upon 4. So this is coming out to be simply, the ratio is 1 is to 1, or simply 1. And that shows, consulting the question, that the element Q in list 1 corresponds to the element 2 in list 2. Isn't it? And checking once again, our choice of option B is correct, because in option B only we are given that Q corresponds to 2. So we are on the right path. That is step number 2. Next, in step number 3, we find the ratio of kinetic energies of satellites. And we know that kinetic energy of a particle has the formula capital K is equal to half mv square, where m is the mass of the particle and v is the linear speed. And therefore, in this case, we can write down the ratio of kinetic energies of satellites is k1 upon k2 is equal to half m, well, m1 v1 square divided by half m2 v2 square, halves cancelling out, you can write it as m1 upon m2 into v1 upon v2 whole square. M1 by m2 given to be 2, v1 upon v2 found here to be 2, therefore v1 upon v2 whole square, that is giving me 2 square, and this ratio is coming out to be 8. Consulting the table, you can see that the element R in list 1 matches with element 4 in list 2. Let me write it here, that the element R corresponds to the element 4 in the two lists. That's for kinetic energy. Let me show you here an alternative method of getting the same answer. If you have done my theory class on mechanical energy of a satellite revolving around a planet, you will find the formula for kinetic energy of a satellite can be expressed as K is equal to G into M divided by twice R. In the formula, this is gravitational constant. Capital M is the mass of planet around which satellite revolves. Satellite's mass is small m, R is the orbital radius. And therefore, you can write down that the ratio of kinetic energies, K1 upon K2, is equal to, for satellite 1, K1 is GM into M1 divided by twice R1. Satellite 2, kinetic energy is G into capital M into M2 divided by twice R2. GM's cancelling out, 2's cancelling out, this is coming out to be M1 upon M2 into R2 upon R1. M1 upon M2 given here to be 2. R1 upon R2 given to be 1 by 4, that is R1 by R2. So R2 by R1 must be 4, and this ratio is coming out to be 8. The result you already got by using this conventional formula here. That's step number 3, and you can see that this shows element R of list 1 corresponds to element 4 of list 2. One more thing to show, that is ratio of time periods. In step number 4, the formula for time period of a particle moving in a circle is capital T is equal to twice pi r by v, where r is the circle's radius, v is the constant linear speed of the particle. So in our case, the ratio of time periods of satellites should be the ratio T1 upon T2, and this is satellite 1, this is twice pi capital R1 upon V1. Satellite 2, T2 is twice pi capital R2 by V2, twice pi cancelling out. We have the ratio R1 upon R2 into V2 upon V1. R1 upon R2 is given to be 1 by 4, and since V1 upon V2 was found to be 2, V2 upon V1, that is 1 by 2, is coming out to be 1 upon 8. Consulting the table, you can once again see, this shows that the element S in list 1 matches with element 1 in list 2. So you can write that element S from list 1 is matching with element 1 in list 2. So that is the end of this calculation, but I already have said steps 2, 3 and 4 are shown here for sake of completeness. You already have got the correct option in step number 1, and you must stop there because time is valuable in competitive examinations like this.